Hi, I'm Emily, and I'm going to take you through an intermediate GMAT problem. Go ahead and take 2 minutes and see what you can make of this one. So you likely discovered that there were a couple of different routes you could take to solve this. All of them require a pretty firm knowledge of exponents, but some of them are still better than others. The answer choices are all non-simplified exponential terms, meaning one option would be to go through every single answer choice, simplify it to essentially a single term, and then compare them. And that would work. But that's also going to take you a lot of time. So notice a couple of things. First of all, this question is asking you which of these has the greatest value. Meaning, we can almost think of this as process of elimination. So rather than trying to compare all five terms at the same time, I'm going to grab any two that look similar to each other, that look easy to compare, and I'm just going to determine of those two, what's the greatest term? And the one that's less is wrong. So let's actually start with this first one here. And let's compare it to this guy down here because they're both 3 with 2 exponents, so they're relatively similar. Now, 3 to the 4th to the 12th is the same thing as 3 to the 48th. And 3 to the 90th to the 1/2 is the same thing as 3 to the 45th. So clearly, you compare these two, the one that has 48 threes is going to be bigger than the one that has 45 threes, so we can say answer E is incorrect. We also now have a relatively simple number to use to compare to the other three answer choices. So right now, our front runner for the biggest term is 3 to the 48th. Take a look at C. C has got 3 to the 30ths. Now, make sure that you are very clear on how to simplify this. We're not going to add the 30s or multiply the 30s or anything like that. One way to think about this is we have 3 to the 30th 3 times. So literally 3 to the 30th times 3. You can even think about that as 3 to the 31st, which is way smaller than 3 to the 48th. We have a bunch of 3 to the 30ths. Those are teeny tiny relative to 3 to the 48th. So that goes out. I'm going to ignore the one with the 4 for a minute because that might make things complicated. So let's instead go to B. B has got absolute value signs, which really doesn't matter to us at all because all the exponents are even. Everything's going to turn out to be positive. It's not as if we're comparing positive and negative numbers. So I'm essentially going to ignore those absolute value signs. I'm going to look at B and say this is 3 to the 30th times 1/10th, so 3 to the 3, times 12, so 3 to the 36. Again, way smaller than 3 to the 48th. That guy's out. Now we have our absolute last one, the only one that involves a term that's not a 3. And this is where things can get a little bit tricky and you've got to be completely confident with what exponents mean. So 3 to the 48th literally means I have 48 threes lined up together multiplied by one another. 4 times 3 to the 47 means I have 47 threes lined up multiplied by one another, but then also multiplied by a 4. So these two numbers are almost exactly the same. The difference is, if I convert this down and I say this is 3 to the 47, it has an extra 3. So it is 3 to the 47 plus one extra 3 tacked on to the end. This one's got 47 threes, but rather than a 3 tacked onto the end, it has a 4. That is going to be very slightly bigger than the one that's multiplied by 3. So our final answer is going to be answer choice D, 4 times 3 to the 47th. What I want you to take from this is a couple of things. One, have your exponent rules down cold because you're going to have to be able to manipulate quickly. But two, when you're asked to compare answer choices, don't assume you have to compare all of them at the same time. Take them in the order that makes the most sense and break them down piece by piece, eliminating as you go. This is all about strategy and process, not so much about doing a lot of complicated math. Subscribe for more GMAT Math Spotlight videos from Manhattan Prep and leave a comment telling us how you solved this one. Happy studying!